Hello everybody, this paper is about colored Petri nets which often need to be unfolded for exploring the model behavior. This brings us to the question, why do we use them in the first place when they need to be unfolded anyway? Let's consider a timely modeling challenge and we start off with a basic epidemic model comprising three compartments. Next, we allocate to the transition firing rates and simulating the model generates traces like this. Now let's turn this epidemic model into a pandemic model. And please note everything what I'm now going to show you is joint work with David Gilbert and Jen Connolly from the Brunel University, London. In our understanding, pandemic modeling requires the notion of space. So we take our basic model and by copy-paste we get a second location. Let's consider Germany and France, and people like to travel, so we add transitions for the symmetric movement between both locations. Well, this was pretty easy, and we basically know how we would have to model more complicated spatial scenarios, like this one comprising 5 countries, or 10 countries, or even whole Europe, or China, or the USA. Well, I guess you got the point. We do know how the models have to look like, but it's hardly possible to construct them manually. So what we do instead, we take our basic model and we color it. Here you go. First, we introduce a color set comprising all locations we want to consider. We add a variable x and we specify the initial marking. Now what we got is epidemics evolving in every location but so far independently. To turn the epidemic model into a pandemic one, we add movement. But not all locations are directly connected, so we add guards, constraining the movement by a Boolean expression. To implement the guards, we introduce a few more color definitions. We add the color set matrix. Next, we introduce the direct connections as a subset type of matrix. And finally, we define a color function to be used in the guards. Now our model is ready, and by automatic unfolding, we get what we were looking for, the pandemic model for the 5 countries considered so far. We can replace the color sets implementing the connectivity graph, for example, by 10 countries. Or we take entire Europe, or China, or the USA. So we have one colored model serving basically as a template, and the only thing which needs to be changed are the color sets and the initial marking. Now we are ready to simulate our pandemic models and to explore their behavior. There is one question left: how to unfold efficiently this kind of models involving many non-trivial guards? Well, when you want to know, I recommend to read our paper or to try out our tools. All supports the unfolding as discussed in our paper. Thank you very much.